Okay, boy. Excuse me?
Because if they did, they can get lost. I have never been so insulted in all my life. Really, laughed at. Balderdash.
What are you doing?
Are you quite certain you're not a spy?
A spy?
Those wretches will do anything to destroy me. My theories are correct, and I can prove it.
What theories?
I am the leading amateur paleontologist in the nation, and not one university will hire me because, unlike them, I actually have ideas.
You're a what?
I study dinosaurs. You know, big lizards.
Are they real?
Of course they're real, you nincompoop. And everywhere.
Everywhere?
This state was once a vast, shallow sea that had the most incredible animal that could walk, swim, and fly. Quite unique. I call it Totalosaurus. Just for now. I'm trying to gather all the evidence. Miss Deborah McGinnis?
Arthur.
Good to meet you. Could you give me a hand here, please?
Of course.
Yeah. Listen. If you find any of these bones around the country, send them to my homestead at Furwood Rise in Cumberland Forest. Or mail me the locations. I'll reward you handsomely for your efforts.
Sure. Why not?
And we'll be proving a lot of stuck-up buffoons very, very wrong. Which, trust me, is the very best thing about science. Good day to you, sir!
Mr. Morgan, I took your advice, sir. I took your advice.
Then your god has finally deserted you. What you talking about?
I took your advice, sir. I have removed myself from Morpheus's embrace. No more shall I sink, sir. I am free. I am free.
You don't seem free, friend. You seem drunk.
Sit down, Reverend. We ain't finished.
You ain't finished. Look at him, he's finished.
None of us forced liquor down his throat. Friend, I just want him to play.
Now, firstly, we ain't friends. Don't make no mistake on that subject. Now, secondly, he can't hardly see, let alone reason. Now, reasoning ain't never been one of my strong points neither, but seeing I do just fine. You want to step outside or do a business here?
I just want him to finish the game.
Why can't we all just get along? These are good men, Arthur. They're children of God. They're children of God.
Oh. How's about you playing his place, huh? That seems fair.
Fair?
Sure. You want a game?
Sure. I'll play a few hands.
Well, sit yourself down then. I'm Luther. This is Marvin.
Fortunate for you both, we're being gentlemen about this.
Same goes for you.
So, how you two know each other anyway? Don't seem like the likeliest of friends, if you don't mind me saying.
We go a long way back.
And now you're his chaperone?
I guess it's something like that. Can we play?
He can't be no real clergyman. He committed about 5 cardinal sins just in that chair you're sitting in.
I think he used to be. He's drifted a little in recent years. Life is a challenge to all of us.
Can you imagine him at the pulpit? If he could stand up.
On the 4th day, he turned water into whiskey, and I don't remember much after that.
Call.
He's a decent fella going through a bad time. Disrespect him again, and you'll find yourself in a bad time, too.
All right, all right. Just trying to have a little fun here. It is a game, after all, mister.
Yeah, I know. Pretty pathetic.
I'll call.
There you go.
Hardly a big finale from me.
Don't laugh.
Huh.
Darn it.
Mm-hmm. Yes. I'd better fold.
That's the way it goes.
Let's start this low for now.
Okay.
Nah. Okay, then.
Look at his face.
That's more like it. All right!
Ain't this a fine old time? The best.
Just not the same without a slurring clergyman, is it?
check. Here, just a little.
Come on. At least make it interesting.
I know. It ain't too exciting. Forgive me. It's all I can afford.
Come on. Is that it?
Not for me.
Yeah. Yep.
Damn it, I can't get a look in.
You one unlucky bastard, eh? I'll see you.
I check.
Check for me.
Check.
Not just a little wager.
Yup.
No. Have a look.
Only just.
You gotta be kidding me.
Yeah, it all counts, huh?
Gentlemen, this is getting too rich for me.
Sit down.
Oh, I'm done, friend. It's been a real education. Come on, Rip. Where is he? Where'd he go?
Who?
The Reverend. Where it? Excuse me, gentlemen. Reverend! Reverend Swanson! Where'd you go? Excuse me, I'm sorry. You see a drunken idiot, a priest, wandering about?
Sure, we saw him, smelt him, and avoided him. He went that way, I think.
Thanks.
Guy looked kind of crazy, mister.
Get your hands off him now, you son of a bitch!
What the hell is your problem?
He's with me.
I'll kill you both! You're going... down!
Stark killed him. I'm gonna keep the law on you.
Hey, get back here.
Oh my God! Killed him! I'm gonna get the law on you!
Hey you! Get back here! You better stop right there! I said stop, damn it!
Okay, okay. Please, don't hurt me.
Tell anyone what you saw back there? You're a dead man. You understand me?
Yep. I won't tell a soul. I promise.
On second thought, you can give me all your money, too.
Okay, here, just take it. Just please let me go.
This never happened. Okay. Reverend! Get off the damn tracks! Over here! Come on! A friend! It's just a simple mistake! You can still be saved! Done with your foot!
It appears to like this place. It wants to stay.
Get your foot out of here! Twist your leg, you drunken bastard! Help! Help! Get it! Come on! You.
What the hell is wrong with you? Throwing me off a bridge like
there
that?
There was a goddamn train, you crazy bastard!
Have I been bad again, Mr. Morgan? I'm sorry. I wish I was different.
Let's get you home.
Home? Yeah, that's a wonderful idea. I could have tea with Margaret.
Margaret? Who's Margaret?
But...
Okay, boy. Yeah.
I told him! Amen!
Mumbling about now.
When he'd show up.
You better sleep your way to salvation, my friend.
What happened?
Just the usual.
Poor bastard.
Exactly.
Well, thank you, Mr. Morgan. I'll keep an eye on him.
He was lucky this time. Real lucky.
Always first in the food line, aren't you? You ain't far behind me.
Lenny?
Hey, Arthur.
That knife's sharp enough, ain't it?
Depends. Why? You feel lucky?
Do you?
Oh, before me, at least 6 generations were born in chains. And for the last 3 years, I've been running from every lawman and bounty hunter west of the Lanahassee River. So yeah, I feel lucky. I'm the living embodiment of luck.
That is one way of seeing things.
But I'm also skill. And in this game, you got to have luck and skill.
And stupidity.
The outlaw's trinity. Luck, skill, and just a dose of stupidity. Come on, you ain't too old. Old and too slow just yet.
After you.
As you wish. You know, We should head back up that mountain sometime and make Jenny a proper grave. Some night. Remember, if you want to back down, you just say the word. Son of a...
So you want to play, huh? A hand.
Bye.
You been on the run again?
Ah, hello, Mr. Morgan.
Here, let's get.
Yeah.
Head still rolling.
Space here, will you?
Whatever do you want?
Mr. Thomas Downs? You owe me money.
No, I'm...
Oh, come here, you maggot.
Please, sir. I'll...
Really? Threaten me, would you?
Please. I have a family, sir. Please.
I don't care about your family. Why did it have to come to this, huh?
Believe me, sir. I didn't want this either.
You ain't such a do-gooder, are you? If you're running out on debts...
I'm not running anywhere. I'm doing my best for you. Mr. Strauss seems so understanding.
You are a slippery little bastard. But I got you now.
Please, please, show some compassion. Please. Please. Please, no.
You borrowed money from my business partner, Herr Strauss. You owe him. You took the money. He wants it back. What's not to understand? Where's our money?
I don't have it.
Sell your place.
We already owe more than it's worth.
Then sell your wife, or your family, or something. We ain't your idea of charity. Is that clear?
Thomas!
What are you looking at?
Thomas!
I said, what you looking at, woman?
My husband isn't well. If we could just have more...
Like I said, we ain't nobody's idea of charity. Get us the money!
Uh...
Ah, how did you get on?
Not so good. He's almost dead. And they seem more or less destitute. You were a fool for lending them the money.
Well, people who aren't desperate don't seem so interested in my propositions.
Of course.
On the grass again. Sun, slow down the
Whoa, I'm trying to sleep here. Hi, Arthur.
Where the flowers have been. But the heart throbs on as warmly now as when the summer nights were nigh. Oh, the sun never dipped so low. Down affection's cloudless sky. The sun can never dip so low. Down affection's cloudless sky. 100 months outside.
Thank you.
before. You're okay, boy.
Yes?
Oh, I'm sorry. I didn't mean to disturb you, ma'am. Is Mrs. Linton in?
I'll go see. Mrs. Linton, a caller for you.
Hello, Arthur.
Mary?
I heard you and your friends was around.
Okay. Where's what's his name?
Died.
Well, I'm sorry to hear that.
Yeah, me too. Happened a while ago. Pneumonia.
Bad business.
Sure.
So, you've been... you've been made a widow and you come here looking for me, is that it?
No, ain't like that, Arthur.
Ah, okay.
My family... I need your help.
You mean the family that always looked down on me? You want me to help them?
It's my little brother, Jamie.
I always liked Jamie, at least compared to the rest of them.
He's broken Daddy's heart.
Daddy has a heart?
Don't make me beg you, Arthur.
My money, my life, me. I wasn't good enough.
I'm sorry. We need your help real bad. Little Jamie's joined the Chelonians, that strange religious order.
Good for him.
They're quite mad, Arthur. They'll kill him. You're the only person he'd listen to.
So, I'm too rough to marry into your family, but it's okay to ask me to help in saving your family.
I'm sorry. I understand if you don't want to help me, but... but I think of you often.
Long time ago now.
I'm begging you, Arthur.
I say let Jamie live Jamie's life and not the nightmare that his daddy dreamed up for him.
Jamie's so innocent, Arthur. Please, Arthur. Will you help me?
Where is
it? Somewhere out near Carmody Dell, I think. The rancher there said he'd seen him around the Cumberland Forest area. I just want him back, Arthur. If you find him, bring him to me at the station.
I'll see what I can do.
I'll owe you.
You already owe me.
ankle something fierce. Think you could give me a ride?
Yeah, sure. Hop on.
Oh, thank you, sir. Thank you. You know Emerald Ranch? Mind taking me there?
Sure. Yep.
Glad I ran into you. Huh. I raised that horse, you know. Raised it since it was just a foal.
Losing a horse is hard. Sorry to hear that.
Yeah, that horse did right by me. Better than my husband, truth be told. That fool. Always complaining. But does he do something about it? Man barely lifts his hand to wave the... Flies away, aside from to lift a drink, of course. Marriage for me has been nothing but trouble. But Biscuit, he was a fine animal. Loyal, smart, brave. Didn't take no guff, not from no one. Had one of them mountain boys pull a gun on me once. I was riding up near the Dakota and had stopped by and... You aiming to knock me off? Please, quit riding like this. Okay, just let me off. I'll walk from here.
Yeah.
Might as well just have left me to walk.
Ago, the great Chelonian master led pilgrims across the Lanahassee into the wilderness.
Gentlemen!
Shell of safety.
Can I speak to the boy?
Arthur?
Hello, son. Your sister is very worried.
The boy has chosen a path, sir. The path to truth.
Well, his sister just wants to speak with him.
Arthur, I've chosen a path.
The boy has chosen a path. He's chosen safety. What path have you chosen, sir?
I'm still searching, I guess.
We are all searching. Chelonianism is about searching. What do we search for, do you think?
I don't know. Safety? Safety and meaning?
Jamie. Knows the truth. But of course, you may speak with him.
Exactly. If your teachings are so great, what harm can I do?
I'm not coming with you, Arthur!
Just come and speak with Mary, then make up your mind!
Leave me alone, Arthur! I didn't ask for your help!
Let's talk about this!
I was doing just fine by myself! Sorry!
They're just using you! Telling you what you want to hear!
What the hell do you know about it, Arthur?
God. Come on, Jamie! Your sister's worried about you!
This is none of your damn business!
sakes, Jamie, just hold up a minute. Come on, you ain't stupid. You can see this is crazy.
You're the crazy one.
Yep. People?
They're my friends!
Let's go!
Chelonia.
Leave me alone, Arthur! I didn't ask for your help! Arthur, I'm a man now. I found something. A calling.
You're just a kid. You're making a big mistake.
I'm not taking advice from you. You're an outlaw. You leave me alone. They're good people. I'm warning you, Arthur Morgan. Leave me alone.
Please, kid. Put that gun down.
I warn you, Arthur! I don't want to live anymore!
Kid, just calm down.
Leave me alone!
calm down. Let's go see your sister.
Okay. Okay.
It's okay, kid.
Have I been a terrible fool, Arthur?
I don't know. I don't know enough about it. But one thing I do know, there ain't no shame in looking for a better world.
I missed you, Arthur. Are you and Mary sweet on one another again?
Oh, no. That's all a long time ago, son.
Yeah.
Well, this wasn't how I thought today would turn out.
It's been a long time, Jamie Gillis. You were a kid last time I saw you. Didn't try to kill yourself.
You know, you taught me how to ride a horse.
Too well, apparently. Chelonia, though? Really? You'd fall for that?
They were very nice to me. They're decent.
I'm sure. Please tell me you didn't give them any money.
Of course I did. They rely on charitable donations.
Jesus, Jamie, come on.
I just wanted to believe that there might be something good coming my way one day. Guess that's dead in the water.
With the turtle.
Shut up. All Father kept telling me was, you won't amount to anything. You're not enough of a man. I had to get away. I couldn't take it anymore.
Forgive me, but your father's a bully and a coward. Don't listen to him.
Hey, don't talk about him like that.
What do you want me to say, Jamie? He's a good father, nice man.
He won't be happy I saw you.
Please send him my worst regards.
The thing is, he's right. I'm not good at anything.
Come on, that ain't true. Tell me something you like. Don't think too hard.
Apples, I guess.
Apples?
Yeah, I love apples.
Okay. I was thinking more along the lines of carpentry or horses or something, but all right, go work in an orchard then.
By that token, you must really like shooting and robbing people.
I only like shooting young idiots who run away from me when I'm trying to help them.
Father told me what you do.
I'm sure he did.
Are you still with Dutch and what was his name? Hester?
Hosea. Yep, still the same, sort of.
And Annabelle and Bessie?
I'm afraid they're dead.
Shit. Maybe Mary did make the right choice.
No doubt. But none of it is anything like the nonsense you read in the newspapers.
So, are you two getting back together?
I told you, no. Just ask me for a favor.
You know Barry Linton's dead? Pneumonia.
He told me.
So the door's open, so to speak.
That's all in the past. Different people now.
She's not. You seem just the same.
Well, maybe that right there's a problem. She was always too good for me. Here we are. She must be waiting inside.
You're nervous about seeing her, aren't you?
Good boy.
Father's been very sad.
Father wouldn't know sadness if it died in his bed. But I'll come home for you.
My boy. My sweet boy. Come on. Oh, Arthur. Thank you. Thank you.
It's good to see you, Mary.
And you, Arthur. And you. Oh, you'll never change. I know that.
I feel like the luckiest man alive, and I feel like a fool. That woman confuses me and plays me for a fiddle like no one else alive. I trust I will not make a god-awful fool of myself once more, but somehow I imagine I shall.
Here. Maybe this is our man.
You a bounty hunter, mister?
Maybe. It depends.
Well, I'm guessing you ain't here to pass the day, turn yourself in, or discuss the finer points of county law. Then I don't need to know much more than that until I got a reason to.
All right.
You smell that? This here's a livestock town, mister. Tracks delinquents and reprobates like flies. Now, I'm not a feller to pass a quick judgment, but I've been around long enough to know you don't hire a saint to catch a sinner. You bring me what I need, and I'll pay you well, and I won't ask no questions.
So, what is it you need?
Why don't you have a look at that poster on the wall over there?
He's a low-down huckster. He's been poisoning folks with his miracle cure from here to Annsburg. Killed more than Landon Ricketts without even pulling a trigger. Gets some kind of sick satisfaction out of it.
Feller over at the saloon says he thought he saw him by the gorge straight north of here.
You think you can bring him in? The money's good. I need him alive, though. I want to make sure the women he witted get compensated before he swings.
I'll see what I can do.
Well, good luck to you.
And we need him alive. That's an important point.
Alive, I got it.
In need of a good story?
I'll take a paper, please.
Catch you some other time.
Good evening, partner.
Who wants the paper?
The damn government is taking people from their homes. That's it.
Hey, move!
This ain't good. Hey! Well,
partner.
Good God.
Hey there, cowboy.
Hello there, sir. Don't think I've seen you around here before.
Excuse you.
Hey, folks.
Hey there, partner.
You best not cause no more shit around here.
Right then. What'll it be?
Looking mighty fine.
Me and the missus had one hell of a blow up.
How many is that? You are 1 week flattered, son of a bitch.
Fine head of hair we got to work with here. This here's a cut for a stand-no-nonsense man.
Things going okay?
Thanks, mister.
Things been kind of normal. Just keeping myself busy.
Evening, mister.
Thanks for your assistance.
Taking people from their homes, messing with their minds, and turning them on their own family.
Hello there.
Boy. Are you Benedict Albright?
Oh, sir?
Huh. Kind of look like him. And I was told he'd be up here.
No, not me, sir.
It's because I want to buy some medicine. And I heard him. I heard good things. I'll pay in gold. If you could help me find him, it's just...
My mother's real sick.
Oh, well, if that's the case, for a sick woman, I'd be happy to help. I'm a healer, you know? A medical man. Finest medicine in the state.
Game's over, mister. Put your hands up. I'm taking you in.
Taking me in? What for?
Apparently, that stuff you're pushing is killing folk. There's a price on your head. I don't know. It ain't my business.
Come on, partner. That's crap. I'm a healer. I got an aura. I speak to spirits. I'm a scientist. Folks get real angry for no good reason. This is a mistake.
Keep your hands up, buddy. They only want you for questioning.
I have to insist that this is a mistake.
Don't be a fool.
Hold on. I'm slipping. Shit. Please. Oh, shit. Sorry.
Seen that way.
Where's that horse going?
Not again.
Valentine used to be a nice town.
Hale never would have seen it coming.
You hear about that old rancher? Got stomped to death by one of his cattle.
Too much for me.
You never go the way you hope to, do you?
Expected.
Oh boy, that's enough of that for today.
What do you don't understand anymore? And that's the truth.
Oh my lord, I wasn't expecting you back so soon. Mrs. Calthorpe was just leaving.
Sure. Where you want him?
I'm selling the back.
There's been some terrible mistake. I never did it. Any of it.
I thought I told you to shut up, partner.
But I told
but
you.
But nothing. Shut up. And, good luck. It's been real fun.
You ain't much of a man. You ask folks for forgiveness, you remember this, partner.
I've already forgotten. Now, sure, how much was you offering?
$50. Here.
Thank you. Madam.
Please, remember what I told you.
Now, my heart was feeling like about time we went on a test.